Nze mpewo empisa bubi era senga enkubo yabadde etonyi tewandinsanze nga njoza. Nsiiba mu nnyumba n'ebikkiridde. Kale obulwadde buno tebwagala nnyo mpewo kuba amagumba gayinza okkumeketa n'owulira ng'ofa.
Agnes Namudu, aged 61, is believed to be the second oldest person living with sickle cells in Uganda. This basically makes her the oldest woman, the first one being a male. Namudu says out of three children in the family, she's the only sickler. She explains how her parents told her about the condition.
Auntie Rambu, bangamba, nti nalini mazee wiki bili kunsi. Muyokusatu ne ntandika okulwala. Ne bantwala mu ddwaliro buli musujjala gwankubanga ng'akeera mpijaawo. Peyini kale zaatandika okujjawo obanga nina emyaka nga asatu. Kale wali mu biseera by'ofuna embuto awo. Nawo peyini zaalingawo nnyo ng'oluto bwe luba luvaamu lunuma nnyo.
Although she knew about her condition before marriage, Namudu says she did not disclose her condition to her partner, who later discovered. Namudu explains how this condition barred her from having children.
Embuto ezo
zali meka?
Mwenda.
Mwenda.
Naye emyezi mukaaga, musanvu, ena. Kati n'obufumbo ne bukyankalana.
Nga zivaamu buvi.
Nga zivaamu buvi, saafuna ku mwana mulere naye nga zivaamu mu muntu abeena n'omutwe. Nga bwe guti. Kale yasembayo yangamba munabaana munafu.
Ruth Nankanja Muchibi is a mother of three and has lived with sickle cells for 49 years. Just like Namudu, she was the only sickler in the family. She advises parents with sick children to always seek medical assistance. She also narrates her story.
I was diagnosed at 6 months old. And at 6 months, I got swellings of the fingers and the toes. And my parents thought maybe the nanny that was keeping me that time had messed up with me. So they took me to hospital. I also got anemic, but they tested me before they gave me a transfusion. And they found out I had sickle cell disease. I was in and out of hospital most of the time. Like in a term of 3 months, I would say I would keep in school like a month.
Dr. Edward Chisache, a specialist working with Mpiji Health Center for Sickle Cell Clinic, explains why Namudu is able to live this exemplary life.
For Namudu, first and foremost, it's a unique case because ideally, in the time I've spent in the field, Namudu is a rare case. So most of our friends, the sickers, I mean, we call them warriors. The maximum they can go around 30 years. So I think Namudu, adherence first and foremost. Adherence and taking doctor's advice, so serious, and exercising. Just as I said, home remedies. These sickers should take plenty of water. You need to drink enough. Together, they always get dehydrated, and which leads into complications. Then also diet. They have to feed so well. But with feeding so well, it comprises of drinking and taking nutritious foods or seeing a dietitian to advise.
He also updates on the sickle cell numbers in Mpiji district.
With Mpiji where I work, we have over 250 sicklers and the eldest is 61 years. That is a miracle, but most of them are around below 18 years. Most of them, they are below 18 years. And those who try to push it up, they reach up to 30 years, then one or the other, God takes their life.
Dr. Annette Nachirulu, a hematologist at Mulago Hospital Sickle Cell Clinic, highlights on how sickle cells can be prevented and further explains on how to take care of a sickler.
When a mother is carrying a gene for sickle cell and a father is carrying a gene for sickle cell, there's a chance that the child may have sickle cell. So if sickle cell, we denote it as SS, meaning that a child has inherited an S gene for sickle cell from either parents and ended up with sickle cell disease. We have the carriers. The carriers, one inherits the non-sickle gene, while the other one inherits the sickle gene from either parents. And that one, and the carrier usually doesn't have the disease, but is carrying the gene for sickle cell. We have painkillers that we give. These painkillers we give in case of what? Crisis. So there is management during crisis and management when there is no crisis. So, and we have another very good drug called hydroxyurea. It's a is a disease modifying therapy. Generally, it doesn't cure the disease, but it modifies that disease so that the disease does not injure the health of a patient so much.
Uganda still records between 20,000 to 25,000 sickle cell births every year, according to Dr. Charles Chiaga from the Minister of Health, head of Sickle Cell Prevention Unit. He explains the latest statistics.
Every year we have 20 to 25,000 babies born with sickle cell disease every year. We have high burden areas, and these high burden areas are these Lango and Acholi region. These are high burden regions. Busoga region. We have Teso region. Then we have Bugisu region around I don't know whether we would call that Toro, Busia, those regions, not the mountainous part of Bugisu, but the mid east region, where you have Budama, Busia, you have the Bugweri, those regions.
Dr. Kiaga says plans to screen all newborn babies and setting up screening centers across hospitals are underway.
Do you want to start innovations where we do newborn screening, and then we identify children before they start getting sick. Within that window, you have a very high chance that you will reverse the negative impact of the disease.
Uganda will join the rest of the world on 19th June 2023 to celebrate the World Sickle Cell Day. This year, the World Sickle Disease Day theme is Building and Strengthening Global Sickle Cell Communities, Formalizing Newborn Screening, and Knowing Your Sickle Cell Disease Status. A call to recognize the first step, understanding the genotype in infants and adults in fighting sickle cell disease. Report compiled by John Musenze for the news.